Guys, how long has it been since we've done a figure on this channel? Oof. My favourite sculptor, John Rosengrant, sculpted it. G'day, John, if you're out there. Hope you're doing okay with all this stuff that's going on in the world at the moment, keeping safe. And he also painted this box art as well. You've got to appreciate an artist that can actually sculpt as well as this. But not only sculpt as well as this, but they can actually paint as well as this as well. It's pretty annoying. One night scale or whatever you want to call it, 200mm. Just have a quick look at the box. I absolutely love the stance of this guy. And at the time when I saw this face, if you get on the internet, it won't do it justice on the box art here. But if you actually get on the internet and have a look at this figure close up, when I actually looked at the face, I think it might have been in a magazine or something. At the time, as I said, it may not show up on the box art. I actually thought this face was almost photoshopped on the front of the figure because it just looked so real at the time. It was pretty amazing. Now let's take a look inside. So it was actually reasonably packaged well at the time, but I will say when I picked both of these figures up, the same figure, one came out and it was there was no damage on it. And the other one came out and the MP was actually broken. So that was a little bit disappointing considering when you have a sculptor that goes through the effort of actually sculpting such a nice kit for it to be broken. I don't know if it was broken in the actual, you know, postage of the figure or whether it was broken and they just threw it in the bag broken. So you never really do know, really, to some degree. Well, let's just take a look at the lower section. And I've got to say, right from the start, very happy with the casting on this. Very cleanly done. Again, I do like it when you actually have to actually search for the casting line. Some figures you'll just pick it up and you'll straight away you'll see the casting line and it'll stare out at you like a pair of dog's jewelry, if you know what I mean. But this one here, it's actually done exceptionally well. As you can see, it's really nicely done. The bread bag, the little buckles here, the button. You've got a little bit of a lip underneath there, so it's sort of not dead flat. It sort of tucks in probably at a bit of a 45 degree angle, if you like. So it's not dead flat, which is also nice. You've got part of the stick grenade there, which again is embedded into the uniform. Obviously, John's work, he's done, I don't know, heaps and heaps of German figures, so he knows what he's doing now. And given that he used to cast his own figures, he obviously, you know, he's in the understanding of the process of casting as well, which also benefits when it comes to the end result of the figure. Always nice to see. If you've seen one of my a couple of my other videos of the Warriors figures, or is it, I think it's PMC, John's 1/9 scale German soldier with the MG42. If you have a look at this video, you'll understand why I really like this sort of stuff, how you have the little holes and the pegs to go into for the boots. Quick look at the torso, and again, same stuff, beautiful sculpting here, and the casting. Buckles are done exceptionally well, there's no missing bits broken off. The holes have a bit of depth to them, quite a bit of depth actually. The belt buckle is extremely well done. Looks like there might have been a little bit of a chip off the old belt buckle there, which is a little bit of a shame. It could be in the bag. See how we go with that. At least it's only the flat part of it. It's not the actual, you know, engraved part or the part that's sticking out, if you like. I love how it's got the deep recesses between the two collars. You can see the casting line down the side here, as I was talking about with the, it was a bit harder to find on the trousers, if you like. It's a little bit more prominent here. But I'm guessing that most of the time the arm's going to go over the top of this, which we'll have a look at the moment, so you probably won't see that. Over this side, you hardly notice it at all. straps at the back, really nicely done. All the little buckles here, the holes in the straps, that's very cleanly done. And again, the little, whatever you want to call it, the O-ring at the back here. A little stitching around the leather. All done really nicely. So we do have a bit of a casting block here, so unfortunately that's probably not going to fit exceptionally well on top over here at the moment, because it's going to block it, if you like. I'll put on a bit of an angle for you, hopefully, an idea of what we were dealing with. The beautiful creases in the uniform and the folds. So, geez, that fits in well. Did that show up on camera? Mamma mia, look at that. Just, it's a bit like my, what was the model seller one, the, with the, you know, the German motorbike rider and the German Shepherd, I believe it was, or do they call them Alsatians? Anyway, beautiful work. Not much putting required there, if any at all, actually. Look at that. That's a fantastic fit. Let's have a look at the other one. Here's the other one here. Look at the laces on that thing, guys. I don't know if they'll show up, but geez, that is cleanly cast. We'll whack this one in, and again, beautiful fit. If you are a bit of a figure modeler, one of the first things you like to do, well, I like to do anyway, like to look at the head. And probably one of the best people in the business that do heads, I would say, is John Rosengrant. And I'd also say that probably he is one of the best people at doing hands as well. If you've got some of John Rosengrant's hands that he sculpted, absolutely amazing. Just the tendons in the hands and the veins going through them, absolutely incredible work. We'll just put the helmet on as well. See, there's a little bit of a casting block there. I don't know why they did that at the front and not at the back, which is interesting. I thought they would have done that at the back. I thought it would have made more sense, but there you go there. Let's have a little quick look at the arms here. And again, there's probably some little casting issues here. They're probably going to stop it from getting on perfectly, but I'll just show you the arms as well. Push that on. It's a nice join line there. And at the back, you can see there's a little bit of a casting block there, but it's also a nice join line as well. The other one here, we're going to run into some issues, but you can sort of see here there's still a little bit of a casting residue there, so it's probably not going to fit on just as well. But it's pretty amazing they've done the two pegs, and they've also done a little slit in the side as well, just so you can actually get the connection point exactly where you want it. Again, absolutely beautiful creases. Just trying to find the casting line down the side. Very hard to find. I can just see it just on the side, just around here. But other than that, and up here a little bit, but it's not going to be too much of a trouble to get rid of that. On this side of the arm, it's even harder to find, especially coming up here. Very hard to find, but over this side, you can sort of see it just a little bit here. But then it sort of seems to run into the seam line a little bit. All the other little parts are sealed in this little plastic bag. We'll have a little quick look at those. As I said before, with my other kit, the same figure, I actually had this snapped off a little bit with the machine gun, which was a little bit disappointing. I think it was a pretty clean break, but I just thought I'd mention that. Pegaso, if you're out there listening, it might be good if you're going to do the gun to put it in a bit of a separate bag with maybe some foam around it, you know, a bit like what Andrea does with their stuff sometimes. Sometimes I think Andrea's stuff's a bit of overkill, but I think especially for the guns and anything else, maybe like a strap or something, if it is very fragile, you might be better off just wrapping that up in a little bit of foam. Or some other people do it, but they should put a piece of cardboard backing and they sort of just tape it to that, which gives it a little bit more protection as well. Which, you know, either way, foam or cardboard backing, I think is a good idea. So with the gun here, we'll just see if this sort of fits in here. Oh, look at that. I wasn't expecting that, but here we go. I thought it wasn't going to fit in. But we'll just give it a bit of a push on, and look at that, guys. Oh, that's pretty impressive. I'm pretty happy with that. In fact, I'm very happy with that. Look at that. That's an incredible join. It's a friction fit. And I've got to say that that is impressive. And obviously, the other arm here, you've got the little indentation, if you like, or hollowed out part of the sleeve. And his other hand just goes in there like that. Again, another fantastic fit there. And while we're here, we might just whack this on, just to give you a bit of a look from there. So that's going to go together very quickly indeed. And I'll just give you a bit of a quick look at the smaller parts. All of these parts are sculpted very well. You can see the texturing on the water bottle with the holster as well. Nicely done. You've got the straps there for his helmet. The magazine pouches are done nicely. This here is done very crisp indeed, and there's not too much breakages. Sometimes around the lens here at the front, you'll get some little breakages around the front, around the rims of the lens, but that's all done nicely. There's no sort of missing parts there. And also on the back here, if we have a look, that's all done exceptionally well as well. I'm hoping they'll show up. The stock for the machine gun is also done very nicely. And of course, you get the strap for the gun as well, which you don't get too often in some figures. So you might need to probably put that in a little bit of warm water or hot water just to bend that to the way you want it. I'm a big fan of John Rosengrant's work and his sculpting. I think the actual sculpting is absolutely, obviously, first class. And another positive is you can see the front of the barrel here. It's all sort of hollowed out quite well. If you've been thinking about this kit, I highly recommend it. I think it's a cracker of a figure kit. Bought by myself, not given to me for a review or anything like that. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll catch you later.